The loading capacity of roof structures is significantly influenced by wind. Wind load on structures is very often underestimated, which is why we address this issue in the video. Since the effect that wind has on structures is a very complex matter, we will only touch on a few basic points. The first point is the relationship between wind speed and the resulting wind pressure. Wind pressure can be calculated with the following formula. The pressure in kilonewton per square meter is equal to the squared wind speed in meters per second divided by 1600. The effect of the quadratic equation can be easily shown. A wind speed of 10 meters per second results in a wind pressure of only 0.0625 kilonewton per square meter. Doubling the wind speed to 20 meters per second results in a wind pressure of 0.25 kilonewton per square meter, which is four times more. The second point is how the wall and roof covers react. Wind loads on normal buildings are borne by bending of their rigid walls. The flexible canvas on temporary roof structures, on the other hand, reacts to these forces via tension. This membrane tension is considered in structural calculations using a simplified mathematical approach that can be explained by the following animation. At the end of the day, wind load is borne by the truss elements. The membrane bulges due to this wind load. This bulging requires an elongation that causes tension inside the membrane. The amount of tension is considered in accordance with the European standard for tens EN13782 as an additional loading of 1.25 times of the wind load. Unfortunately, this membrane tension significantly decreases the loading capacity of the structure because a large part of the truss loading capacity must be allocated for the wind loads and the membrane tension. The third point is the misconception many users have regarding the self-weight of temporary structures, which often leads to underestimating ballast needs. The seemingly heavy self-weight of the structure is perceived as being enough to counteract the wind forces. Unfortunately, in most cases it is not. This can be shown in the following example of our MR2 roof structure. The structure's self-weight is approximately 1300 kilograms. According to the standards, which must be taken into account, a wind blowing into the front of a roof structure generates an uplifting force of approximately 5300 kilograms. A horizontal force of approximately 3500 kilograms is experienced simultaneously. Hence, an additional mass of ballast is required to secure the structure. The functionality and calculation of this ballast will be addressed in a further video.